Week, and here we go from Three River Stadium. Warren Moon has played there 20 times before as a member of the Oilers. Robert Smith, and very soon he's going to be known as Shoeless Robert Smith. The Steelers gang tackled the shoe. Smith is gone. Touchdown, 7-3, the Vikes.
Robert Smith shows some great vision here as he cuts back initially after getting the football and then gets back to the outside. He has a nice burst once he gets to the corner. You very seldom see him not be able to turn that corner. He loses the shoe there, proving it must not be the shoes, Chris.
It is not the shoe. Hope those socks don't smell. 10-6, Vikes, 2 seconds to go in the half. Dennis Green has Reves kick a field goal. He misses a 48-yard field goal, but Gordon McCarter says 12 Steelers on the field. Bill Cowher says, wait a minute, there were not. We're going to count them for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 down there, 6 up there, 7 on the line of scrimmage, 8 on the line of scrimmage, 9, 10, and there's 11 over there. Cowher says, wait a minute, I got pictures to prove it. But the call stays. This time the field goal is good, 13-6. And you talk about Cowher power. He says, look, here they are. You take the pictures. I'll autograph them for you after the game. In the second half, Cowher's ire would further be drawn because Bam Morris, it pops out. Corey Fuller picks it up after the Del Rio hit, gets into the end zone. 20-6, Vikings. It would get worse for the Steelers. First and 10 of their own, 22, Mike Tomczak to Charles Johnson. Picked off again by the Florida State rookie, Corey Fuller. Vikes couldn't move it, but Tommy, then what happened?
Yeah, you're going to see Alvoy Mays at the top of the screen tell Andre Hastings to come his way so he can level Chris Walsh right there. Walsh would be okay after that hit.
Well, they did well on the special teams, but other problems elsewhere because Tomczak had the rough Monday night game picked off by Alfred Jackson. And Cowher says, I think we need to make a change. Two plays later, Warren Moon would drop back. And all Chris Carter does is catch touchdowns. 27-6, Tom. They make a quarterback change. Jim Miller in for Tomczak.
Yeah, and he drops back. Jeff Del Rio gets the pick. He's going to lateral to Orlando Thomas. Look how he made sure Thomas was behind him before he gave him the football.
Two defensive touchdowns against the Steelers this year, two all of last year. Still in the third quarter. It would get worse. Jim Miller overthrows Yancey Thigpen. Orlando Thomas is there with the interception. It's a broken record. 6 interceptions, 3 of Tomczak, 3 of Miller today for the Vikes. Last year, the Steelers were intercepted just 9 times. 13 this year. 78 interceptions over the last 52 games. We got more numbers than we could shake a stick at. Bill Cowher knows all of them are bad. Here's the worst number. Vikings 44, Steelers 24. Robert Smith with a 100-yard day. Chris Carter caught 6. Warren Moon has passed the 60,000-yard mark in career passing combined NFL and Canada. That's 34 miles. Afterwards, Cowher went the mile to talk about the call at the end of the half.
Today was a debacle. For officials to sit there and not be able to count 11 people, and it's a debacle. It's embarrassment to the National Football League.
Well, that is true. I mean, we saw the pictures later, but yet...
The other points.
What happened with the other 41 points? I mean, little did we know that Dennis Gibson knocking down the ball in the AFC Championship game and in the goal line would be the turning point for the Steelers last year, and as it's turned out, this year.
Well, I think the thing we need to point out is that this is a different football team.